The state-run pension fund Social Security System collects over 39 million pesos in unpaid contributions from the National Capital Region. This is part of the fund's efforts to run after contribution evaders, or RACE campaign, which was relaunched in March 2023. RACE is a program meant to help financially distressed employers settle their dues while ensuring employees can still avail of social insurance. Sardine manufacturers sound off a looming price hike, citing soaring fuel and fish costs. Sardine makers say they may jack up retail prices by more than 3 pesos. The president of the Canned Sardine Association of the Philippines, Francisco Bombit Buencamino, says they will insist on the price adjustment despite an appeal by the Trade Department to hold off any price hikes until year-end. Buencamino instead urged the government to look at other areas of the industry to keep prices down, such as tariffs imposed on imported tomato paste and tin plates, which are used by canneries. Processed meat manufacturers are also citing higher raw materials and operating costs for the price hike. The group's vice president and spokesman, Jerome Ong, says they're spending more on imported raw materials, while the string of fuel price hikes is driving up their transport and distribution expenses. The Philippine Central Bank moving in lockstep with the Fed. The Banco Central left its benchmark rate at 6.25% during its policy meeting on Thursday. It says risks to inflation continue to be on the upside from weather disturbances, higher oil prices, and the 6th in July. BSP Governor Eli Remolona is not ruling out a rate hike in their fight to bring down consumer prices.
Looking ahead, the BSP stands ready to resume its tightening actions in the face of upside risks and potential adjustments in transport fares, potential adjustments in second-round effects that could dislodge inflation expectations. The Monetary Board also reiterated the need for non-monetary interventions, including temporary reductions of import tariffs with calibrated volumes and timely arrival of import commodities.
The National Economic and Development Authority says it would support moves to ban Philippine offshore gaming operators or POGOs from the country, saying it would only support businesses that promote social development. We have more on that from Job Manahan, who joins us on the line now. Job.
Ron, good afternoon. NEDA on Thursday said it would personally recommend the banning of Philippine offshore gaming operators or POGOs from the country. It says that support moral and social development, given that POGOs have been linked to crimes and other issues. He added that social costs were high compared to the revenues that POGOs provide. The NEDA chief added that those investments must produce goods and services and not the ones that supposedly promote negative externalities to society, such as those alleged crimes or unrelated issues. Aside from this, Balisakan said whatever revenues that would be lost from POGOs would be gained from other investments. He cited those in Thailand and Indonesia that do not depend on those kinds of businesses. His statement came after at least 10 senators signed the Senate Committee on Ways and Means report recommending the immediate expulsion of POGOs from the country over 6 months since the report was finalized. Under the committee report, the Senate urged the Executive Department to cease the operations of POGOs. Ron.
Job Manan with that story. Thanks, Job.
The National Printing Office wraps up the printing of ballots for the upcoming village and youth council polls. Victoria Tulad has the details.
The National Printing Office, or NPO, has finished printing more than 92 million official manual ballots for the Barangay and Sangguniang Kabataan election on October 30. In a turnover ceremony at NPO this morning, Director Renato Acosta, Director 4 of the agency, gave the SKE, such as more than 403,000 election returns and 87,000 sets of certificates of canvas and proclamation. More than 2 million official ballots for the October 30 plebiscite to ratify the conversion of the city of San Jose del Monte, Bulacan, into a highly urbanized city have also been finished. As for the more than 110,000 ballots that will be used for the three areas, where automated elections will be pilot tested for BSKE, COMELEC spokesperson Attorney John Luis Claudianco says NPO will start printing tomorrow and might finish within the day. The final testing and seeing of vote counting machines that will be used for this will be done today to ensure that the machines are able to properly read the sample ballot. Laudiaco says commission and audit employees oversee the printing and conduct of all NPO and COMELEC personnel. Acosta and Garcia assured the public that they will be transparent with their processes.